Game on, everybody, and welcome to another video. In this video, I will attempt to predict the new Yu-Gi-Oh! Ban list that is expected to come out no earlier than March 30th, 2020, just in time for the new Master Rule 5. This isn't my personal predictions, just what I think Konami will do in preparation of the new format. As a reminder that the ban list is not only just to fix the game from problematic cards, but it also helps sell new product. I will give a little bit of personal input, but that being said, here's what I think Konami will change on the ban list. As a reminder, if you are interested in any of the cards that I mentioned in this video, please feel free to use my TCG Player affiliate link in the description box below. I would greatly appreciate it. Starting off in the Unlimited section, we have Tour Guide from the Underworld. She not only could promote the Burning Abyss archetype, but possibly also a way to promote the new Lair of Darkness theme monster coming in Eternity Code, Malice, Lady of Lamnit. She is also getting an altar art, which could help sell the product Dual Overload. Next, we have Deep Sea Diva. Konami has been slowly peeling this card off the ban list in preparation of selling the new archetype. Next, we have Pantheism of the Monarchs. Making this card back to Unlimited can only boost the deck's consistency, which it desperately needs, but doing this won't make the deck tier 1. Reasoning I think is relevant for Infernoids, and sure, they have some tops, but the OCG has it unlimited and it's not horrible. We also have hard counter cards to graveyard strategies such as Soul Drain. Pot of Avarice to Unlimited wouldn't be such a bad idea. Knowing Konami though, they might slowly move it off from Limited to Semi-Limited and then eventually Unlimited, but even at Limited, like it is now, does nothing. Speaking of cards that would do nothing at Unlimited is Draco Faceoff. Pendulum strategies, although it's the best deck, aren't running wild. There are also better counter pendulum strategies out there. Unless there's some crazy combo that I don't know about, please remind me why this card is limited in the first place. Symbol of Heritage is a card that is limited to one copy. How often does this effect come up? You need three monsters in the graveyard with the same name to activate this effect. All the good cards for the most part are semi-limited or limited. What cards could come up that could make this card broken? If it was truly broken, why is it limited to one? Please let me know why it is here. Otherwise, I think it can come off the limited list. Trickstar Light Stage. This card was used primarily as an engine facilitator, but it's being limited to one Hertz Pure variant of Trickstar strategies. The main abusers of this card were Orcus strategies, but now Orcus cards are not once what they were as top meta contenders. Our first extra deck monster that I'll mention is Gem Knight Master Diamond. Now relax as I say this because there is other hits to Gem Knights that I will mention later in this video. I'm not crazy about FTK strategies, this will make more sense later in the video. Lastly, on the unlimited list, I have Ritual Beast Ulti Kanahawk. Ritual Beast strategies need some love, and unlimiting this card shouldn't have any meta relevance impact to the format. Besides, the more diverse the format, the better in my opinion. Thanks for sticking through with me. Let's continue with our first card on the semi-limited list. The first two cards kinda go hand in hand. I have Seer and Graf from Burning Abyss. It'll boost up Burning Abyss strategies to be more consistent and a bit more meta relevant. Let's talk about Baby Sarasaurus. This is a great card, but I imagine Konami wants to sell its new Jewel Beast Argosaurus in Eternity Code. Necroz of the Unicorn can help the consistency of Necroz strategies. It won't make them tier 1, but it can help counter extra deck summoning spam strategies. A Hero Lives being semi-limited could also really boost hero strategies. This card requires you to pay half your life points as cost. Sure, they can act as extra copies of Stratos, thus boosting the consistency of heroes, but this additional card won't make them broken. Hero decks spam the board, and the best counter to their strategy, in my opinion, is Nibiru. That usually puts them in their place. Terraforming might actually become semi-limited. This is wishful thinking due to it being reprinted in Dual Overload. Two would be great for many field spell strategies, except the most infamous one. More on this later. As much as it pains me to say this, although not seeing meta relevance this format, Galatea the Orcus Automaton might get semi-limited. This deck in pure versions can play two, but this can really impact their grind game, which Orcus is so well known for. Konami just might want to ensure new decks have a moment to shine, and just in case, power check Orcus. Konami, please don't do anything to Orcus. Deck does get hit though on the ban list and still manages to top. Konami might want to semi-limit Salamangreat Sunlight Wolf. This would hurt the consistency of the strategy, but really good pilots of this deck will still be able to do really well. Okay, so keep in mind Master Rule 5 is just around the corner. Konami might want to make some precautionary changes, so here's what I think they will do for the limited list. Blaster Dragon Ruler of Infernos could potentially come off the ban list. Konami might be looking at the Dragon Rulers to slowly come off the ban list. Up next, we have Spiral Master Plan or Spiral Mission Rescue. In my opinion, I think Master Plan should probably get limited to one due to its Rota-like effect. This hit wouldn't be too harsh in my opinion, just a consistency hit that hinders the link-based strategy the deck has with spamming the board. Let's talk about Eclipse Wyvern. This card was banned because of Thunder Dragons, but that deck is really hurting. Would it really be so wrong to bring this card back to one? Lunalites need to be checked. Lunalite Kaleidochick and Lunalite Tiger is just too good, especially when it comes to Master Rule 5. If this doesn't get adjusted, then Time Thief decks will for sure abuse this engine. Instant Fusion is going to be pretty insane in Master Rule 5. It quite possibly could even be banned, but I think Konami might just limit this card. The best target for this card is obviously Millennium Eyes Restrict, and that card is getting reprinted. That is why I think it's going to get limited instead of being banned. Okay, let's talk about Harpy's Feather Duster, which I think could come off the ban list. Unless Konami is still trying to sell Lightning Storm, then it won't get unbanned, but realistically, this card can come back. Mind Control is too strong. Konami might straight ban this card, but they might do the usual 3, 2, 1 limiting like they do. Fossil Dig could potentially be limited. Again, the reasoning is to possibly sell the Jewel Beast Argosaurus. Double Evolution Pill also just got reprinted, so maybe they can try to push that product. Brilliant Fusion to limited. Okay, hold on. I know I said Gemknight Master Diamond to be unlimited. You haven't seen what I banned yet. Like I said, I do not like FTKs and I'm sure Konami doesn't either. That being said, keep watching to see what I think could be a better option for the Gemknight archetype. Invoke cards are great, however, they are being slightly abused. I don't think the problem is Alistair, nor do I think the problem is with Invocation. Magical Meltdown is honestly the card that is getting abused in Shadals. Invoked Pure needs all the help it can get, so leave the core alone. I put Vanity's Emptiness on the list. This card is getting reprinted and can really slow down special summoning spam decks. It can be easily outed as well. One copy wouldn't break the format. Some cleaning up from the extra deck as we approach the new Master Rule. I will try to keep this quick. ABC Dragon Buster can be pretty scary at multiple copies. Shula, Dragon of the Ice Barrier, because of hand looping. TG Hyper Librarian, because of draw spamming. Junk Speeder causes a lot of synchro spamming and totally awesome. Multiple copies can be abused for multiple negates. Lastly, I have Thunder Dragon Colossus. From unlimited to banned was too harsh. I think it can come back to one. Okay, so with Dual Overload being the hot product, many cards cannot exist with the newly released product. Crystron Halky Fiberax, Union Carrier, and Predaplant Verte Anaconda are just too good. Both Mist Valley Thunderbird and Dragon Buster Destruction Sword cannot be healthy for the game. Basically, you better have your Dark Ruler No More ready to handle those infinite negate boards, or a main deck out to eventually allow you to gain access to your extra deck. Blackwing, Steam the Cloak, Mecha Phantom Beast, O-Lion, Global Bulb are all one card combos with Halky Fiberax, and typically one card combos get taken care of swiftly. Mystic Mine should be banned, so field spell strategies can strive. So many decks played as a one-off to stall for their strategy, but this card really hinders decks that rely on the field spell. This is also why I mentioned Terraforming can go to 2. A lot of people really don't like this card, and if it doesn't get banned, all I can say is make sure you main deck Cosmic Cyclone. What I mentioned by how this card can really hinder decks that rely on field spells is that we don't have extra copies of field spell searchers. If Mystic Mind gets banned, we can incorporate more copies of Terraforming and possibly Metaverse. Alright, let's make sense of all the Gemknight releases. Gemknight Lady Lapis Lazuli is the main facilitator of the Gemknight FTK strategies. Get rid of this and we shouldn't have any issues. There is also an Adamantia strategy that can do the FTK if Lady Lapis is legal. True King of All Calamities is overall pretty degenerate of a card. I am still surprised this card is legal. When there is a will, there is a way to abuse this card. It promotes zero interaction and in a card game, that is no fun. And finally, we have Guard Dragon LP. Argapain hit was just not enough to stop Dragon Link spam decks. The Dragon Link strategy is honestly a sleeper strategy, but it honestly needs to be checked. Guard Dragon LP is a really good card and is regularly abused. Everybody, thank you again so very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give me a like. And if you love the content, consider subscribing to my channel. If you disagree with the list, that is okay. Please leave me a comment why, and possibly what you would do to the forbidden and limited list. Join my Discord, link in the description, and if you want to purchase any of these cards that I mentioned, please use my TCG Player affiliate link. I would greatly appreciate it. I'll see you in the next video. I'm out of here.